Mr. Speaker, I've already given a general statement that sanctions have long been a part of our welfare system, but details around the way our particular policy around getting young people into work will go to Cabinet and decisions will be made collectively. But what I am happy to say is that, unlike the last government, we are not willing to allow more than 70,000 young people not in employment, education or training to have their lives wasted.
Speaker, to the Prime Minister, if a young person who may be eligible for a scheme of this nature refuses to participate or attends for a day or two and then refuses to attend, will the government apply sanctions to them?
Speaker, I've given the general principles that we'll be working to, but final decisions of the programme will go to Cabinet. But again, this government is entirely united behind the idea that young people deserve opportunities, and under this government, they'll get them.
So many questions.
The Right Honourable Winston Peters.
Can I ask the Prime Minister as to whether it's her government's attitude that the wealth of a country is in its working people, and whether it would be refreshing if some people, instead of looking a gift horse in the mouth, decide to put a saddle on its back and be grateful?
Mr Speaker, this is a government that is focused on providing employment opportunities. And that's exactly what our Minister for Regional Economic Development has been speaking to. And unlike the last government, who labelled young people pretty damn hopeless, we'll get them into jobs.
Order.
To the Prime Minister, does the 33-page coalition document contain anything about a work-for-the-dole scheme or any scheme whereby people receiving a benefit might be made to work?
Mr Speaker, programs to get young people into employment were referred to in the document that both parties signed and that is now public and in the public domain. So, Mr Speaker, that is already publicly available because it was in our official coalition agreement.
Yeah, I apologise. I should have actually ruled the question out. I think because no one has yet established that there is a 33-page coalition agreement.
Oh, point of order.
No, you're not going to relitigate this, are you, Mr Bridges?
Well, I think point of order on that matter. I mean, they've accepted it
quite clearly. Mr Bridges, I've apologised for allowing the question. I was too kind to Ms Bennett.